This presentation is about using a tool called Agreed Ace to help you better time insecticide treatments and other pest management practices in your orchards. Use Agreed Ace to predict when susceptible pest stages are present so you can maximize control. For example, you need to apply an insecticide for peach twig borer after the majority of larvae hatch, but before they bore into the ends of twigs where insecticides won't reach them. Use Agreed Ace to pinpoint the best time to kill the most peach twig borer larvae with a single application. Although Agreed Ace are used to manage pests in many crops, we will focus on its application in stone fruits and nuts. In these crops, Agreed Ace are useful for the management of several insects, and for this presentation, we chose different insect examples to show how Agreed Ace can be used. At the end of this presentation, you will know what a Agreed Ace is, what information you need to collect to calculate Agreed Ace, where to find resources for calculating Agreed Ace, and how Agreed Ace can optimize pest management in your crop. Let's define a few terms important to understanding Agreed Ace. The first is phenology, the study of an organism's development and how it's influenced by weather. Ambient temperature influences the development times of cold-blooded animals and plants. For example, as temperature warms in the early spring, trees start to bloom. Being cold-blooded, insects and mites do not regulate their internal temperature. Instead, their development is dependent on the temperatures they are exposed to. Because of this, temperature affects when an insect will go through its various life stages. In other words, when it becomes an egg, caterpillar, or adult moth. Humans are warm-blooded and so regulate their internal temperature. Human development doesn't change based on ambient temperature. For example, a human pregnancy is 9 months whether a woman is living in the Arctic Circle or at the equator. So let's take a little quiz. How long does it take for a peach twig borer egg to hatch? Is it 5 days, 10 days, 11 days, or all of the above? That's right, all of the above. Because how long it takes for the caterpillar to get ready to hatch out of the egg depends on the temperature it is exposed to. This graph shows the average development time from egg to adult for different batches of oblique banded leaf roller, also called OBLR, raised at different temperatures. As the temperature increases, the development time decreases. At 15 degrees Celsius, it takes approximately 100 days for an egg to develop to an adult. But at 25 degrees Celsius, it takes only about 40 days. In the previous graph, it seems that if the temperature kept on increasing, the development time would continue to get shorter and shorter. But this doesn't happen. Below a certain temperature, insects cannot develop. And above a certain temperature, the development slows and will eventually stop. These critical temperatures are referred to as the lower threshold or base threshold and upper threshold and represent temperature limits on insect development. When temperatures fall between the upper and lower thresholds, the insect will develop. Depending on how long these temperatures occur, we get so many units called Agreed Ace, which can be used to measure development. A Agreed Ace is a unit combining temperature and time used to measure development of an organism. 1 Agreed Ace is a single degree of temperature above an insect's lower temperature threshold maintained for 24 hours, or in other words, 1 degree above the lower threshold maintained for 1 day. For example, the lower threshold for navel orangeworm is 55 degrees Fahrenheit. If the temperature is maintained at 56 degrees Fahrenheit for 24 hours, a single degree day accumulates. But temperatures are not constant in the real world. So how do we measure Agreed Ace with temperature fluctuations? Here's a graph of Agreed Ace accumulated over 2 24-hour periods. The red solid line shows the temperatures over 2 days, and the dashed lines mark the upper and lower thresholds. Yellow area, showing when the temperatures are between the upper and lower thresholds, represents the accumulated degree days for each day. Adding the areas under each day's curve gives the total number of degree days accumulated for the 2 days. Once we know the number of degree days required for each development stage of an insect, we have a phenology model. Recall the example of maintaining navel orangeworm at 56 degrees Fahrenheit, or 1 degree Fahrenheit above its lower threshold, for 24 hours. We said that 1 degree day would accumulate. Then the next question is, at a constant temperature of 56 degrees Fahrenheit, how many days would it take for navel orangeworm to develop from an egg to an adult? The navel orangeworm phenology model says that they require, on average, 1,050 degree days to complete their life cycle. Therefore, if maintained at 56 degrees Fahrenheit, meaning an accumulation of 1 degree day per day, navel orangeworms would take 1,050 days to develop. Now let's say that navel orangeworms are placed at 57 degrees Fahrenheit, or 2 degrees Fahrenheit above the lower threshold. Development would be twice as fast as compared to rearing them at 56 degrees Fahrenheit. So it takes the navel orangeworms only 525 days, or half the time, to develop. As the temperature increases, more degree days accumulate in a day, and less time is required for development until the upper threshold is reached. When temperatures are above the upper threshold, no degree days accumulate. Also remember that development time represents an average for a population. So the majority of navel orangeworms will develop in 1,050 degree days, while some individuals will take less and others take more. Now for an important question. How do we know when to start accumulating degree days? Accumulation starts either on a particular date, for instance, January 1st, or on the biofix date. A biofix is an observable biological event, such as the first pheromone trap catch or egg laying. The biofix for omnivorous leaf roller is the date when traps start consistently catching moths. For navel orangeworm, it is when 50% of the egg traps have eggs. So now that you've got a good understanding of the terms commonly used and the basics of how degree days are calculated, let's take a closer look at what it takes to use them in the field to manage your pests. You can effectively predict population trends of an insect if the insect has discrete generations, you know the development thresholds, upper and lower, and the degree day accumulation needed for a particular event. You know when to begin accumulating degree days, and if it's a biofix that signals a start, you have the tools to detect when this occurs. If all these are known, a phenology model can be used to manage your pests. If a phenology model has been developed in a location far from yours, you should test the model for one or more seasons in your area to verify it will predict biological events accurately. A different location presents different conditions an insect is exposed to, which may influence the development of the insect. This also applies for a phenology model developed for an insect in one crop that you'd like to use for the same insect in another crop. For example, at one time we didn't have a phenology model for a bleak-banded leaf roller in California, but one was developed in New York. We performed a field test to verify if the New York model could predict timing of OBLR's growth stages in California. According to the New York model, one generation of OBLR takes 2,000 degree days using lower and upper thresholds of 43 degrees Fahrenheit and 90 degrees Fahrenheit, respectively. The biofix is the date the first moth is caught in a trap. To see how well the New York model would predict California populations, researchers recorded the number of oblique-banded leaf roller males caught in traps throughout the season in a California pistachio orchard. This graph represents the results of a field test. Oblique-banded leaf roller is an easy insect to follow because it has distinct generations that don't overlap. In other words, at the end of the first flight, there's a period of time with no trap catches until the second flight begins. You can see that the first moth of the first flight was trapped in the orchard on May 8th. The first moth of the second flight was trapped around July 15th. And the degree day accumulation between these two dates is 1,918 degree days. According to the New York model, we saw that one generation of oblique banded leaf roller takes 2,000 degree days for one generation. Although there's a discrepancy of 82 degree days between the New York model and our California results, it is not uncommon in June and July to accumulate 20 to 25 degree days each day. This means the difference between the values is only about 3 calendar days. A 3-day discrepancy will not influence whether an insecticide application is successful or not. So, after several years of similar results, we accepted the New York model for predicting oblique banded leaf roller generations in California. In addition to monitoring traps, it's important to keep records of other production and management activities in the field. Here's an example of why. See this dip in the population on August 7th? Without records of orchard practices or events, the population drop could lead to unnecessary speculation. As it happened, this particular orchard was treated with an insecticide targeting another pest on that day. So, what do you need to accumulate degree days in the field to predict treatment application dates? You need the minimum and maximum field temperatures for each day. Weather stations or data loggers like this one record rainfall, temperature, relative humidity, solar radiation, wind speed, or soil moisture and send information directly to computers, including yours. You may not need your own weather station. There are many located throughout the state, and there may be one in your area. To find out, go to the UCIPM website, the California Irrigation Management System, or CIMIS website, or to a commercial network. On the UCIPM website, when you select the county of interest, you will be linked to the information about sites that are recording temperatures. Choose the site that is closest to your farm. Now that you know how to get weather data, let's look at another bit of information you need to have. When to start accumulating degree days if there's a biofix. Grower Bill Chandler is looking for oblique banded leaf roller. Traps are checked twice weekly. When he gets multiple moth catches, meaning more than one moth within 1 week, he will designate that date as the biofix and start accumulating degree days. It is critical to correctly identify the insects in your traps because they can look very similar to each other. The big moth is oblique banded leaf roller. You may think, but I'm using a pheromone trap that will attract only OBLR. Although pheromones are pretty selective to species, in the case of some tortricids like oblique banded leaf roller, this is not always so. A very similar but smaller moth, the garden tortrix, has very similar wing patterns. People have mistaken garden tortrix for oblique banded leaf roller and begun accumulating degree days based on the wrong insect. Garden tortrix emerges almost 1.5 months before OBLR. The advantage of using degree days to time treatments is that they allow you to reduce insecticide use by targeting the most susceptible insect stage, attaining maximum control and reducing costs. Monitoring and using degree days allows for the correct application timing of reduced risk products, preserving many of the parasites and predators that control other orchard pests. There are many benefits to using phenology models. The highest level of control is achieved, pesticide applications are minimized, and beneficial insects are preserved. But getting a workable phenology model takes a lot of research. Because insects and mites are cold-blooded, the temperature around them influences their development, and so their developmental times vary as daily temperatures vary. Phenology models are developed in the lab for pests by determining their upper and lower development threshold and the rate of growth at different temperatures. However, temperatures aren't constant in the real world, so phenology models are refined in the field to estimate developmental times. 1 degree day accumulates when the average temperature is over the minimum threshold for 24 hours. The accumulation of degree days is used to predict when an insect will reach a certain stage in its life cycle. Phenology models for oblique-banded leaf roller, omnivorous leaf roller, peach twig borer, and others, plus more information on calculating degree days and using degree days in your orchard, can be found on the UCIPM website